Wadamuli, welcome. I bring this acknowledgement of country in a spirit of reconciliation with the people of the Burdekin Nation, and out of respect for the partnership being forged between Burdekin Catholic High School and Gujira Reference Group. We gather on traditional country of the Bindu people, Jura people, who are the traditional custodians of this land. Our journeys have drawn us from near and far, traveling across Bindu country to the northern Mau Mau, the Burdekin River, and through the Jura country to the south of the Burdekin River. I pay respects to the elders, both past and present, for they are the keepers of the memories and traditions and stories and culture. They hold the hopes for our future and unity. I also recognize the contributions of Torres Strait Islander and South Sea Islander peoples in founding the Burdekin. It is industries and community. Let us also be mindful as we gather to get together that each of us also brings our own presence, story, and culture to the rest for a time on this country. Thank you, Wadamuli.
Thank you, Fred. In the book of Jeremiah, it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." It's a thought which resonates, as 2020 has certainly presented our students with challenges that have at times tested them and us. It feels as though the restrictions imposed as a result of COVID-19 have denied our students many of the activities and celebrations synonymous with a senior year. And while the tangible experiences may not feature in your memories of year 12, I hope you will look back fondly, not on what was lost, but on what was gained. Facing the adversities presented by navigating year 12 during a pandemic has shaped this group of kind, capable, and resilient young humans, which we gather here to celebrate this evening. And if we were to reflect on the teachings from the book of Jeremiah, it would be hard to dispute that this was not always part of God's plan. I would like to invite our Deputy Principal of Religious Education, Mrs. Emma Timms, to lead us in grace.
If we can take a moment, please, to centre ourselves and be with God our Father by making the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of this food, which nourishes our bodies. We thank you for the gift of our kind and loving family. We thank you for the gift of hard work and have faith that all our dreams and goals will be fulfilled with our perseverance. We are thankful for our wealth of blessings, O Lord, and will keep joy and peace in our hearts. And may our love be steadfast and nourish our souls and illuminate us from within. Amen. Father, Son, Spirit, amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Timms. In a moment, we will be able to share our meal together. Tonight, what I would ask that you do is exit through the doors on this side up the back. The buffet and the service will be just out those doors. When you re-enter the room, if you come around and enter through the doors at the back on this side. We will be inviting you up to get your meal by table, and a number of staff members will come around and tell you when it is your opportunity to do that. So in the meantime, sit, talk, you're able to use the bar, and enjoy the evening. Thank you. Thank you. just let you know that if there's anyone who'd like seconds, there is the opportunity for that to happen. So if you'd like a second serving, just exiting out the same door and coming in the other door, and that's available for you for the next few minutes. Thank you. everyone. If I could just give you the notice that the bar will be closing very soon for the formal part of tonight. So if you'd like to take the opportunity to purchase some drinks to get you through the formalities, which shouldn't take too long, you might want to make your way out to do that now. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so just a reminder, the bar will now be closed while we get on with the formal part of tonight's proceedings. As the class of 2020, you have definitely experienced a very different final year of schooling, and you're to be commended on your efforts and understanding. I would now like to invite Mr. Craig Frattini to the stage to deliver the principal's address.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, staff, and most importantly, our graduates for 2020. Well, you've made it. You've come to the end of your high school journey. Congratulations. You are the pioneers, the explorers of your generation. You have been the first in so many things. The first preps, the first year seven cohort into high school, the first to undertake and complete the new QCE system and external exams, and the first to do so during a pandemic. Being first isn't such a bad thing. In fact, we place a lot of value on coming first. We look to our pioneers and our explorers as an inspiration and to learn from their experiences. So you, like many pioneers and explorers, there have been plenty of rough waters and rugged terrain to navigate and to overcome. Sometimes you probably thought it was getting too treacherous, almost impenetrable, but you've hung in there and you've managed it. You've been able to carve a path, discover the way, to open up new horizons, to set the benchmark, and to create new maps for others to follow. There will have been times when you felt that you were on your journey alone, and perhaps sometimes you were. But most of your journey, you have had an exploration party with you. You've had your teachers, your peers, your friends, and most of all, your parents, carers, and family that have been there with you. They've been there with you to help you to develop the knowledge, to equip you with the skills, to watch you grow and become the fine young men and women here before me tonight. There are moments like these, like tonight, that you have the opportunity to reflect on your journey thus far and to show your appreciation and gratitude to those who have supported you on your journey. You are now at a new junction. You're about to embark on a new exploration, a new journey. I wish you every success in whatever path that you choose, but I hope that you continue to be the firsts, to continue to be pioneers, the explorers, and to continue to make your mark on our world. Always remember, though, to stop every once in a while and take a good look back at the journey and see how far that you've come. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand.
Thank you very much, Mr. Frattini. Our 2020 school captains have led the school body and have been a voice for their peers and representatives, setting an example for our students and future leaders. I would now like to call upon Sarah De Guglielmo, Andrew Dwyer, Zoe Johansson, and Jackson Sticklin to deliver their final address.
Good evening, everyone. We have finally graduated. It has been a privilege to have represented this cohort as school captains for 2020. Despite the challenges presented in our senior year, we have had fun as school captains. 2020 will be memorable. We started our senior journey with a mindset full of optimism and seeking opportunity. However, COVID-19 had other plans. We quickly realized many of the events we had witnessed as members of the junior school would be unavailable to us in our final year.
Among all the negatives, many good things have come out of the unique situations. If we have been unable to get through this year, we will be able to get through pretty much anything in the future. We have been able to overcome unpredictable situations, and hence we have become much more resilient.
We cannot forget to thank the teachers who have guided us through our education journey since grade 7. We are grateful for all the hard work you've put in. Special thanks must go to Miss Loizu, Mrs. Innes, Mrs. Wright, and Miss Scott for being our homeroom teachers this year. A big thanks must go to Miss Roundtree as pastoral coordinator, who has guided us through our senior year since our first day at BCH. A special thanks must go to all the Year 12 teachers who have helped us cope with this unique situation.
We would also like to say a thank you to Mr. Frattini for helping us get through the year despite all the obstacles COVID threw at us. We must express our gratitude to our parents for their unwavering support of us during the past 6 years. And finally, as captains, we would like to thank our fellow students. Together we have grown, overcoming challenges, celebrating the successes, and finally maturing into fine young adults. We wish you all the best in the future. Now please join us in reflecting on a short video that summarises what has made our 6 years at BCHS special.
What will you miss most about our cohort?
I think the thing that I'll miss the most about you guys is actually all of you. I've been really lucky that I've known most of you since you were 4 years old in kindy. And so, unlike a lot of high school teachers, I've gotten to see you grow up from little toddlers into teenagers, and now you're all driving and getting ready to vote in your first election. So I'm going to miss that. And the other thing I'm going to miss is how honest we've been able to be with each other in our classes. I've really appreciated that in the good times and the rough times, but I've really appreciated that relationship that we've had. Good luck.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
If you say the chicken, how the chicken get to the egg?
What's your go-to karaoke song?
What's your favourite subject and why?
Hospitality.
Would you rather fight a horse-sized hamster or 100 hamster-sized horses, and why?
100 hamster-sized horses, because it'd be easier. But, yeah.
Which teacher always brags to the class that you're their favourite? Where would you take your classmates on a trip?
Grandma's house.
If your school life was a song, what would it be?
Help by the Beatles.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
When I went in grade 8 from head to toe.
If you could take one class one last time, what would it be?
Drama.
Would you rather be fluent in all languages or be a master of every musical instrument?
I'd rather be fluent in all languages.
If you could relive one moment of your high school experience, what would it be?
Probably student school.
What's your favourite memory from grade 8 camp?
Miss McBride getting bottomed out on a rock.
What do you think your biggest achievement was at BCH?
Probably just gaining confidence in yourself during the time, stepping out of my comfort zone.
Where do you think you have spent the most time at school?
For me, Andrew's Corner, where the head of the office, where Mr. Pinella named a corner after me.
If you were to become famous, what would it be for?
If I wasn't so white, I could probably be an R&B singer.
What's your favourite memory from your Marine class?
Going near the bone with the Marine kids.
Think before you do, or do before you think?
Probably think before
What's something you will remember most about the 2020 seniors?
Wow, 2020 seniors. What I'll remember most about this group is that we were the first group to go through the ATAR system. Ever since pre-prep, we've been the first of group. So I really admire this group's resilience and coping with all these changes. Best of luck.
Why was grade 8 camp so memorable?
Teacher has fun lessons.
Mr. Marano, we've got a small class and we get to do working group activities, small group activities.
What's your craziest memory from your math class?
It was actually last year because I've had the same class for 2 years and it involves a student called Will who has left. But Will could not get the concept of time zones and he thought that if he went in a plane and crossed over countries, time was reversing itself. Or time was going forward. So it was very interesting and the whole class was in stitches that this student just couldn't get the concept of time zone.
Who was your funniest classmate? Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Probably a few kids, like 7 or 8.
If you were a superhero, what would your superpower be?
My knitting, probably.
What's something that still resonates with you from our Year 10 camp?
What resonates with me the most about this group from Year 10 camp was the whinging, moaning and carrying on. One, when they had to get up early and do a little bit of exercise. Two, the chair game, the carry on and the breakdowns and that, the carry on in there was terrible. They need some more resilience, guys, come on.
The zombie apocalypse, what's your survival plan?
Get them to play.
What's your favourite subject and why?
My favourite subject is fitness because we can bully Mr. Sexy.
What was the best advice you had ever received from a teacher?
The best advice, probably go home and go to bed because that's more important than studying.
Yeah. Describe your typical school night.
I get home, eat some food, do some homework if I feel like it. Watch a bit of Netflix and get in bed.
You don't even chill.
Which teacher could you imagine being your parent?
Mrs. Boise or Mrs. Wright.
Which teacher has fun lessons?
100% Mrs. Boise's literature class.
If you could eliminate one class from the school curriculum, what would it be and why?
Probably math. Thank you.
What's your favourite tuck shop item?
Definitely chucky milk and a sausage roll drowned in Barbie.
What
sauce.
Is your favourite subject and why?
Probably have to go with essential maths with Mrs. Ethorn. Just for the questions that get asked that probably aren't so thought out so much and the little comments that get through here and there. That just
how many chickens game. Would it take to kill an elephant?
Is it a trick question?
What has been your best study habit?
Just taking notes and reading them over and over and over until it stacks.
Who is the scariest person in our grade?
Me?
What is the most embarrassing thing you have ever done?
That time in humanities in grade 10 where I was sitting on my chair and then I fell off it.
If you could give any advice to your younger self, what would it be?
Don't put the dog by
what
the
couldn't you have survived year 12 without?
Getting on the gear of the girl.
What's your best memory from high school?
The sweet chicken chili wrap at different.
What's your biggest pet peeve?
When people ring me and not text me.
What's your craziest memory from your English class?
When we brought to life the idea none of women born from Macbeth, and in my scrubs I assisted a mayor to birth Carter. It was a really valuable learning experience.
What's your craziest memory from your English classes?
The memory is that the lesson is that I should check everything before I show it in class, because my craziest memory was hearing all the swearing in Sweet Country when we played it for the first time last year, and it just went on and
what
on
is your favourite trend or saying throughout high school?
How about it?
What subject do you never want to learn again?
Chemistry.
Who out of our grade would be the worst person to get stuck in an elevator with? Rachel. If you were transformed into a cat, how would you let everyone know it's you?
If I was a cat...
If you could pick a new first name, what would it be?
Sequavius.
What's the most outrageous thing you've ever worn to a dress-up party?
Hands down for sure, it would be at Rachel's party. I dressed up as Kath in her exercise gear, and I like did a full on power walk down her driveway. Trust me, it is harder than it looks.
What song could you listen to on repeat without getting tired of?
Old school, Queen.
What food have you never eaten but would like to try?
I would like to try tofu because I think it would be interesting.
If the world was going to end tomorrow, what three things would you do right now?
I'd travel, drop out of school.
Which teacher has given you the most inspiration?
Definitely Miss Eagle.
What was your favourite touch-up food?
I'd have to say sweet chili chicken wraps, I'd have to say.
Would you rather be a clumsy ninja or a wizard with amnesia?
Well, I'd be a bit of a useless ninja if I was clumsy. I would be very quiet. And if I was a wizard with amnesia, at least if I was a wizard, then I could learn new spells. So I guess I'd prefer to be a wizard with amnesia.
What advice would you give to a younger student?
Always pay attention during class. I always attend to school activities and always listen to peers.
What could you not survive grade 12 without?
Coffee.
What's your dream job?
A fashion designer.
Wait, wake up! What teaching techniques do you find keep your students engaged in HP?
Sorry, I've just been doing a bit of light reading. Kari, just repeat the question, please.
What teaching techniques do you find keep your students engaged in HP?
Yes, so what I like to do is I like to make the curriculum relevant to my students. One way that I do that is I bring my students to the curriculum. So what I find is chopping out the students' heads and placing them on figures through to use my PowerPoints and through my teaching really helps engage the students. So here we have Macy Dabblestein, which was helping with my flexibility training, and we use her as a feature, and we use her constantly throughout. So not only as an introductory slide, but then features as a background. And Macy actually got the highest score in the testing that we conducted for this lesson. No real surprise there. Then we spent maybe, I don't know, 8 hours working on training session designs. And we used Monique Falco here, who's known for her athletic prowess. And once again, not only title slide, but also constantly throughout. Once again, tested everyone in that session. Monique Falco tested the highest in that lesson. I really recommend that as a teaching
strategy.
What's
your favourite memory of our grade?
I have lots of favourite memories. Most of those are when we all started back in 2015 and you were in Year 7 and I had two science and two maths class and you were so cute and eager and wanted to learn. And now you're in Year 12 and still cute, maybe not quite as eager and enthusiastic. But it's been a great year doing lots of things with you, like the Valentine's Day and our crazy socks and $5 formals, and I'm going to miss you all.
Thank you, that was certainly entertaining. I would now ask that our Year 12 students assemble outside through those doors to prepare for their presentation. So if you'd just like to make your way out there now. And while the students are assembling, I'd like to invite Mr. Craig Frattini and our Year 12 pastoral leader, Mrs. Brenda Rowntree, to present the graduating class of 2020 to the stage. And assisting our seniors will be Year 11 pastoral leader and careers teacher, Mrs. Antonetta Delacourt, and senior teacher, Mrs. Paula Sexton, in what may be one of her final acts of service for her students.
Could I please have forward to the stage Blair Alexander? Holly Arthur. Mika Bonato. Shimene Botha. Adrian Byers. Titan Byers. Andrew Cardillo. Michaela Christofides. Frederick Clark Gunawarra.
Macy Dabblestein. Carter Del Santo. Anastasia Davies Horn. Sarah DeGuglielmo. Andrew Dwyer. Indy Everett. Monique Falco. Lexi Favaro. Tayus Skews. Alicia Guy. Rye Hoey. Zoe Johansson. Eliza Licciardello. Georgina Mallon. Alexa Mann. Casey Masson. Katie Ann McAuliffe. Darcy Miller. Amaya Magura.
Hayley Nosworthy. Shaylee Petrus. Tara Piva. Nicholas Predibon. Alana Prevetera. Bella Rapisada. Louisa Reardon. Julius Alden Body. Rebecca Schofield. Jasmine Shaw. Jackson Sticklin. Hamish Swinley. Jaden Thomason. Taylor Thomason. Justice Toms. Rachel Turiano. Matthew Turnbull. Joshua Wales. Bradley Wiggett. Ella Williams. Amaya Wiseman. Abby Woods. Lachlan Wright.
Thank you. Can we just give another round of applause to our Year 12 graduates? Okay, I'm going to invite our graduates back in a moment to have a photo, a group photo. There'll be an opportunity for you to take individual photos yourself of the group, but we just ask that you wait until the official photographer has finished taking those photos, and then the students will be performing their graduation song. So if I could just ask Mrs. Roundtree to bring the students in when they're ready. Okay, we're going to have a very slight change in proceedings. While the students are all assembling, I'm going to invite them to sing their senior song, and then after that they will remain assembled and you can take photos. Well, that was certainly a stirring rendition of the song. Now, I'd like to invite anyone who wants to take a photo of the group to do so now before we get to the final part of proceedings. Thank you. if there are any grad hats on the table, could I ask that you bring them up for the students now, please? Okay, what we're going to do now is I'd ask you to join with us. Oh, hang on, a few more grad hats. So I'll ask you to join with me in counting down from 10 before we release some special celebrations for our 2020 graduates. So if we're ready, starting at 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Please congratulate the graduating class of 2020. Okay, to our senior students, this will be your opportunity to exchange your grad Kindle gifts. So if you would like to collect your gifts from your table and present them to your recipient, the front of the steps, you may do so now, please. Okay, if I can have your attention for one last time. We would like to thank you for joining us this evening in celebrating and recognising the graduating class of 2020. To our graduates, your future awaits you, but please remember the doors and hearts of staff at BCHS are always open to you. There are sweets and coffee available for you to enjoy out the back where dinner was served. So from us, good night and God bless. Now, I realise I told you I wouldn't be talking again and interrupting you. However, I've had a special request if all the students who were in Miss Wanda's kindy class, if you could come to the front for a quick photo, please. So all the students who were in Miss Wanda's kindy class. That should be the last from me. Thank you.